Cultural astronomy is basically the anthropology of astronomy. It looks at how people view the night sky. If you look up in the night sky, you'll see that there's a smorgasbord of cultural material up there. Star names are often from Arabic. Constellation names are Roman. Constellation figures are usually Greek. And the brightest stars in each constellation bear Greek letters. And these are just vestiges of the cultural interactions that occurred long ago. A good example of this is the constellation Orion. If you go outside in mid-December and look to the east, you'll see Orion rising above the horizon. The constellation we know as Orion in Greek is a hunter. This constellation figure derived from Babylonia, where it was a heavenly shepherd. The same group of stars in portions of India are seen as a deer surrounded by hunting dogs. If you go back to Arabia in the time before Islam and for several hundred years after, this group of stars was known as al-jawza'a. Now, it's likely that in its original sense, this star name referred to just the three stars that we know today as the Belt of Orion. This woman, al-jawza'a, was engaged to be married to a man named Suhail. Now, Suhail lived across the river with his two sisters, together called Ashariyan. When the wedding night came, everyone was happy and celebrating, of course. And Suhail and al-jawza'a, at the end of the evening, went in to consummate their marriage, and something happened. Somehow, al-jawza'a was dead by morning. Now, Suhail feared for his life, and so he fled far, far away to the south. One sister crossed over the river and headed towards the south to be with him as well. Another sister decided to stay home, but cried and cried because she had lost her brother and also her other sister who had crossed over to be with him. This isn't just a story, it describes stars in the night sky. We've already seen al-jawza'a, a trio of brilliant stars. Suhail is a very bright star, the second brightest star in the whole sky that we know today as Canopus. One of the sisters was called Ashara al-Abor, the Shara who crossed over. And this is the star that we know today as Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky. The other sister was known as Ashara al-Khumaysat. This is correlating with a star that we know today as Procyon. And Procyon is a very bright star, but not as bright as Sirius, her sister. Al-jawza'a started out as this trio of stars that we see as the Belt of Orion, and over time, more stars were added to the figure. She got two arms, two feet, she got a head with long flowing locks of hair. One of her two feet today is known as the star Rigel, and Rigel comes from the Arabic Rijal, which means foot. One of the stars in her hands is known today as Betelgeuse. This is part of why I love cultural astronomy, because looking out into the night sky, you would never know this kind of history about the stars of Orion. When you look up at the sky tonight, take a look closely at those three stars in the Belt of Orion, because it was also the Belt of al-jawza'a.